Every single year, we ask NBA 2K to make brand new hairstyles for the new games. And again, they listen to us. They've only added 7, at least from what I can tell. And I'm going to cover all the brand new ones in this video. ¿Qué pasa to the pack? It is Pack here. If you like NBA 2K25 news, please join the pack and subscribe. Let's go. First up, we have Spiky Short. This is a hairstyle that didn't exist. We have versions of this that are close, but nothing like exactly this. It is what you think it is. It's a spiky hair with no direction of the hair, just naturally, with an attempt of a fade. But because there's no actual fade, it's just a cutoff, it looks so bad in my opinion. Look, I'm glad that they have something that's different. Like, I'm always glad they're adding as many hairstyles as they possibly can. There's just no fade on this hair that it just looks bad, and I would never want to use it because there's no fade. Kind of the same thing with this next one with the undercut short. It's the same problem. Like, I like that they added a slick back hair. Like, you know, I slick my hair back. I want stuff like that. I have a fade. But to have the short hair and long hair, but no fade in between makes it look so horrible. This one's not as bad as the last one. Like, I could see myself maybe using this one. Maybe. Like, with a beard and stuff. Like, I guess I'd be okay with it. It's still not what it's supposed to be. It's okay. It's okay. I'm glad they added it. But it's definitely not perfect. This is the worst one, just straight up. This one's called Short Straight. They've had short straights before. This is a brand new version of it. It is legit long hair. It looks like a rock band kind of haircut, really. It's somebody that's like more not really into basketball, really. But I mean, hey, again, there's players that play the game that have hair like this. So as long as they're adding everything for everybody, I'm happy. Now we're into the more interesting ones. First up, we have Dreadlocks Fountain. So the only issue I have with this one is that there's no physics on it. They do seem to have added some details on it. There is a bit of a fade, a bad one, but there is a bit of a fade. And I do see people using this hairstyle for sure. It's just there is no physics on the hair on the top. So that's going to be an issue later on. But it's definitely hair that people are going to be using. So I'm down. Up next, we have the dreadlock droops. There's two things I like about this one. One, we don't have any like big dreadlocks like these. But second, there's physics on these dreadlocks, which is going to be massive for people when they're using it. They're going to see the hair flying in the wind, moving around, which is always dope. So this is a W for 2K. It's probably, in my opinion, one of the better ones that they added. Pretty good. Oh, Lordy. The dreadlock wicks. So I was like, I remember this from somewhere. Kodai Black has his hair like this, right? So there's no physics on it, but I can see why. I mean, it's not going to be moving, right? Ugh, it's just an ugly hairstyle. I'll just say it. There's going to be a lot of people using it because it's just funny looking, but oof. And finally, this one. So this one was not on the list of hairstyles, but it was in the trailer for My Career in Park, which means, at least to me, that you're gonna be able to unlock this hairstyle in the season pass that they always have. This one's actually pretty nice too. One of the better ones that they've had. Absolutely everyone's gonna be using this one once they unlock it. So another W. So there's a couple good ones here. There's a couple bad ones here as well, but definitely not the worst lineup of hairstyles they've made ever. So I'm down. That's it. What hairstyles do you think are missing from NBA 2K25? Leave it in the comments below. If you like this channel, please give it a sub. I'll see you guys next time.